And welcome to the stream. Oh man, we got a good one today. It's Metal Gear Monday. We're going to do some more Metal Gear Solid 4 Guns of the Patriots, and we are doing Act 4, which is a really good one. It's going to be the Shadow Moses portion of the game. So yeah, this is where some of the crazy stuff goes down, so it'll be good. I think we're good to go, so might as well just get right into it. Let's see here. Oh, I got a PMC commercial. Hold on, I will be right back after doing some audio adjustment, and we will get started. Okay, I think we're good to go. Let's see here. I'm just gonna turn down the gain just a bit. I think my gain knob got, I don't know, kicked up a bit recently. So I've been noticing my voice peaking a little bit, but that didn't used to happen. So I don't know what the issue is, but I think we got it all smoothed out. Okay, we have, I believe, the mission briefing to go first. So we'll just, I don't know, I guess we'll have to watch that. And then we'll be good to go. Also want to make sure that the volume is, you know, adequate, so let me know if anything needs to be, changed here. Those names are they developers or something? Seems most likely. Usually the devs like to get their names in the game somehow. Also that egg. Regular yolks don't do that. Those are some kind of, like, alien eggs. Should get them off the ship. Off the plane
we'll
now.
Launch a stealth nuclear warhead at JD.
I thought you couldn't control the nuke with GW.
We can't. We've taken over their guns and heavy weapons, but the WMDs are still under JD's control. That's where Rex comes in. I know where to find nukes they don't control. Vamp, how long until Rex is ready?
All that's left is the final check. We've identified JD's location through GW.
Awfully close to the legs there.
Abandoned 20th century satellite orbit, disguised as debris.
A clever place to hide.
I figured you'd try to be a little bit more inconspicuous.
Satellite orbit.
Still sticking pretty close.
Nuke. There's no need to worry about the Patriots intercepting it. By the time they realize what's happening, it'll all be over.
Once JD, the core AI is destroyed, GW's priority will rise to one. and all the systems under JD's control will then be ours to command. Now go, prepare our haven.
Yes, boss. What the devil is this?
Rest in peace, Mark II.
The video feed from the Mark II cuts off here.
So, Haven. Yeah, Revan was saying something about that.
In the beginning, the Patriot system was controlled by four AIs, with JD at the top. One of those AIs was GW. The Patriots thought it had been destroyed, but Liquid was able to use it as cover to slip inside the system.
Extend the Mark II's camera. You can't, you just have to put it on the main screen.
GW was one of the Patriot cell AIs. It was installed on Arsenal gear. Emma's worm should have put it permanently out of commission. But Liquid somehow recovered and repaired it. I'm guessing JD must be unable to recognize GW, even though it's inside the Patriot system. It's a blind spot. GW was written off as lost while it was still tied in. Using it, Liquid interfere with the AI from the inside. He made contact under the guise of Big Boss's genetic code. Even the AI threat detection system was fooled.
Haven on the network. Free from oversight by the Patriots' AIs.
It all makes sense now. That's why they made Arsenal go berserk 5 years ago. GW was on board.
Where is this Haven? Where is their base?
Don't worry. Mei Ling is using the position of the Mark II's last transmission to predict the course of Liquid's ship. It's only a matter of time before we find him.
But that's not all Liquid said. Something about Rex being ready.
Rex? You mean Shadow Moses?
Yeah, probably that Rex.
It's Campbell.
The U.S. military's systems are all in Liquid's hands now. The regional systems have all been shut down. Guns are falling silent across the Earth. It's the first total ceasefire in human history.
How's the White House responding? The public?
The president has yet to make an official announcement. But the media is starting to pick up on it.
The information's gonna be controlled anyway.
Not this time. The war economy is ground to a complete halt. It's tough to play down a crisis of these proportions. War economy-related stocks are already going into a free fall.
They must be shitting themselves at the White House right about now.
In any case, America had better sleep soundly while she still can. Liquid's insurrection is about to begin. The first thing he'll do is try to destroy the system the Patriots built to control the U.S.
He's already taken the system.
No. Supreme authority still resides with JD, which the Patriots still command. Which is why Liquid plans to launch a nuclear strike on JD in its orbit.
But Liquid only controls SOP, and SOP only controls guns and small firearms. Unless he gains supreme authority, Liquid can't use America's nukes and ballistic missiles. So how's he gonna launch this strike?
Good question. The U.S. converted its nuclear arsenal to reliable replacement warheads 2 years ago.
RRWs.
Yes. The core of the RRWs is now completely ID controlled by the SOP system. You'd need supreme authority from JD itself to control them. And they can be shut down remotely in case of an emergency.
All the old nukes were pulled out of service when they deployed the replacements.
If Liquid can't use the nukes, then... then what's his plan?
That's it. He's going to use Rex.
What?
Rex was scrapped before the Sons of the Patriot system was implemented.
Of course. The railgun.
They explain it, but I think it's kind of funny how no one ever bothered
Indeed.
To pick up Rex.
Rex's railgun can launch a stealth nuclear warhead into space unconstrained by the system.
Just left to rot in Shadow Moses.
In short, it's the only device they have that is able to launch a nuke. Liquid's going to use it to kill JD and deliver the coup de grace to the Patriots' reign.
Campbell, where's Rex now?
I think you know.
Same place it's always been.
A long-forgotten base in U.S. territory outside the Patriots' control. The place where Liquid made his debut, his monument, off the Alaskan coast. In the Fox Archipelago.
Shadow Moses Island.
If Liquid destroys JD, and his GW assumes total control over the system, he'll have the world at his fingertips. And no one will be able to stop him. Not even the Patriots. You are the only ones who can save us now. Snake, I'm counting on you. Defeat Liquid and put an end to his insurrection.
Yeah, about that. Not sure that he's quite up to snuff.
Enough is enough, Snake. You can't take any more of this.
I'm not dead yet.
That's not what I mean. You can't beat Liquid. He's got the Patriots' own control system on his side. Not only are weapons useless, but the U.S. military is in shambles. And even if it weren't, Liquid's got enough men and machines to match it. Things can't get any worse. Face it, Snake. We've lost.
Otacon.
We never stood a chance.
It's not about winning or losing. No, we started this. And it's our duty to finish it. Sonny.
No! Jack can't go. He's not ready yet. He needs to rest.
Let me go, Sonny.
Snake. He's not ready yet.
Snake.
I'll be fine.
If he can talk without the speakers, he's good to go. Hideous. I'm gonna say it doesn't look that bad. I mean, it probably hurts, but...
Do you see this? I have no future. In a few months, I'm going to be a weapon of mass destruction. You have a family.
I have no family. I have nothing. I have always been alone.
Up Night for Pride, welcome to the stream. He has no future because he's ugly. No, though that was kind of the impression they gave. More like, he's going to be spewing poison.
This is my fight.
At some point.
My destiny.
Alright, so I'm just gonna put Bryden back in the bed.
Dr. Emmerich?
Mei Ling.
It's been a while.
I got the results back. It's official. He's on Shadow Moses Island. We lost Metal Gear Mark II's signal along the way, but the ship was headed in the direction of Shadow Moses. This is a picture of the island taken by a civilian imagery satellite. The sea line is rising due to global warming. Have you heard that the entire Fox Archipelago is about to slip into the ocean? The surrounding islands have already been evacuated.
Liquid's arrival there can only mean one thing.
He is going to use Rex.
That's how it looks from here. All the Metal Gears after Rex were embedded with system IDs.
Then what about Rex? What did Washington do with it?
The nuclear disposal facility on Shadow Moses hasn't been touched since the incident.
That was 9 years ago.
I think I always say this, but I miss Mei Ling's accent. Even miss Naomi's accent, and I don't even like her.
By the time the Shadow Moses incident was over, there wasn't a single person left there who knew what took place.
Shouldn't have gotten rid of him.
It was as if nothing had ever happened. The data was either falsified or erased.
One of the many sins of the Twin Snakes game.
We were exiled to desk jobs for the same reason. Rex and the nuke should still be where they were 9 years ago. Untouched.
A forsaken island. A haven.
Well, I'd say it's more like a forgotten island. And it's sinking too.
I thought I'd never go back.
It'll take me a while to get there, but I'll be backing you up from aboard the Missouri. She's the only ship in the fleet still able to move, since it was decommissioned before the system was put in place. And Hawaii's not that far away. Otacon, you're not wearing your glasses anymore.
Oh, I switched the contacts.
We rendezvous at Shadow Moses.
Well, there's gotta be the ladies' man.
Submits to heaven shall live. He who defies heaven shall perish.
Okay.
I have to atone for my past, too. Rex is a beast. Born from
my
research.
Otacon tried his hand at reciting poetry.
Let's go.
I think he should have kept it up.
Shadow Moses awaits.
Snake, do you remember pre-ripped jeans? Alrighty. Ah, yes. The old MGS1 segment. God, I gotta get used to the controls. Really, it hasn't even been that long since I played the original Metal Gear Solid. Still think this is the definitive version, though. So excited when I got Twin Snakes. I'm like, oh boy, an update. I usually like, you know, remakes and such. How disappointed was I?
Huh? Oh, whose footprints are these?
Okay, so I always take the, this way. Okay, don't stop and look at it. I always go up the stairs. That's just something I've been doing for years. Okay, come on. There we go. Nice and simple. Snake, you used to look like shit back then.
Having that dream again.
We're here.
Total of 12 polygons.
Shadow Moses.
Boy, here we go. This is typically like everyone's favorite part of the game. It's a really good segment. I think they do a good job with updating and recreating the old Shadow Moses base. But there's some insane stuff that goes down here, so I am ready. Twin sons. No.
Yeah, I just slipped a little.
Ah, there we go. Feeling better.
Have to hurry. Not much time left.
Meet the Mark III. It's our last replacement,
it's
so
dead.
Try not to break it.
Who, me? Never.
One more thing. I don't see anybody around, but there are unmanned sentries patrolling the area. Be careful out there.
I don't think any of this stuff is worth getting. I'm probably full up on ammo anyway. Yeah. Let's see. Just do a little better. Ooh, look at that. Okay, so I do remember, like, Gecko Irving class being around here. Actually, I might be a little lost. Maybe I should switch to night vision. That's a little better. Yeah, there we go. Actually, I should do the face camo as well. There we go. Okay. Here we are. it's going the other way. Good. I think there's something down there, like rations or something. Oh no, it's noodles. I can see it from here. I don't think I really need that. Blizzard's clearing up just like a tiny bit, but not really that much. Oh boy. Oh boy. Alright. Surely it won't walk into the tree. Sorry, you're just gonna have to see an ass bobbing up and down for a little bit. Oh, the best is yet to come. So yeah, there's gonna be a lot of audio flashbacks. I'm probably not gonna go for all of them, but let's see if I can grab a few.
Wow, you must be crazy to fly high in this kind of weather.
Who's that?
Nice to meet you, Snake. It's an honor to speak to a living legend like yourself.
There's also ghosts you could take pictures of, but I don't think I'll be doing that.
A surveillance camera.
It's great coming back here, but then it's also slightly depressing. Giving me mixed emotions. We have to get the, I forget what it is. Is it a 5-7? I don't think it's a 5-7, maybe not.
A little bit, at least. You can get in that way if you want.
The Mark 23, ah. Well, sell it anyway, I already have one, but... same thing. Yeah, we gotta do this, too. I think he says something. Maybe not. I'd be tempted to do this for a little bit longer, but it's really hard to see. Come on, Snake.
The overhead view. Just like old
There we
times.
Go.
Now you're talking. Overhead view. That's more like it.
Now you're talking. Right on. Alright, so we'll go up. Always go through the vents. I've never gone through any of the lower vents. Never gone through the front entrance. Because why should I? It's always more fun anyway. Get the little rats to see and...
Snake, this is McDonald's.
Get the biller thing.
Campbell told me about the situation here. I thought I might be of some use.
There's no one I'd rather have in a foxhole than you.
Well, I know lots about you.
Yeah, what do we got going on here? Ah, yeah. Yeah, the dwarf gecko. Pain in my ass. I don't think there's really anything worth getting, so probably what's gonna happen is when I get down there, I'm just gonna throw a chaff grenade and make a break for it. also codec calls you can make to Otacon, but I don't remember exactly where the specific ones are at.
Taking the duct, eh? Still remember
one.
Where the exit is?
Yeah, I'll be fine. Well, I remember it. These ducts aren't that complicated. And my old friends are still here to show me the way. I won't get lost.
Friends?
Friends. Little furry ones.
Little furry?
Never mind.
Also, thank you, I'm in BZBT2. Thank you for the follow. Let's take a look. What's in here? What is that? A storage? Thing is, I think with this particular save, it's like my fifth. Oh, look, there's the rats. Fifth playthrough, so I'm pretty sure I've collected most everything. Look at all these gecko, though. It's just, it's not worth it. I don't know. I might as well just check every area to see if there's a... Oh, shit. Codec call available.
To get to the
all right. Okay, I don't have any. Oh, I do have chaffs equipped. Good. Okay, that should make things pretty simple then. All right, come on. Let's go. Let's go.
Could you be Snake? Are you Solid Snake? Solid Snake? The legendary Solid Snake? You?
Don't worry. You'll land back on it. The reality is no magic.
All right.
I unlocked the cargo
gecko in the hallway.
Where I can see ya.
It's not still Claymore's here, is there? No, didn't look like it. Oh well. I never knew there was a path up here until maybe my last playthrough. I guess I don't need any of it, but whatever. Come on, where's the gray fox thing? Oh, there it goes.
Snake, be careful. There are Claymore mines around there. Who are you? One of your fans.
So I think I better switch out that operator. I'm a big fan of that. Boy, oh boy, I don't know. I want something a little heavier hitting. I could do the railgun, but... Let's do that. 50 cal. Oh yeah.
Look out! Run, Snake!
Oh god, oh god, oh shit, alright.
Aim for the legs, knock the gecko over, then aim for the neck.
God, I hate the noise they make when they fall over. Creepy. Okay, come on. I didn't think it was actually gonna see me. I just peeked out a little bit. Oh well. I think there's like music or something down here. Yep, I already got it. You know, I still don't think I have the trophy for, having all the iPod music, but I think. Some of it you get through particular emblems or something, and I don't really remember, but, I have a feeling that's the case.
Whoa, what the hell was that? That gecko must have been in hibernation mode or something. One minute it looks dead, and then BAM!
Tell me about it. I think I almost had a heart attack.
Seriously, though, Who'd have thought Gecko had that kind of operational mode?
Whoever made him must have been a real bastard.
From now on, you'd better keep both eyes on those Gecko. You don't want to get fooled like that again.
No disagreement here.
I think we have another call here about the tank. Let's see. From Metal Gear Solid 1.
Hey, Snake. Isn't this where you went toe-to-toe with Raven and his tank? Tell me again, how did you take that thing down, anyway?
How? Well, grenades.
That's it? You didn't use an anti-tank missile or something?
Didn't have one.
Your technique is kind of... how do I put this? Archaic when it comes to fighting tanks. Honestly, I don't think it'd work on today's main battle tanks.
Well, that's how I did it. What do you want me to say?
You know, I asked an active duty army officer once. If an infantryman had to take on a tank one-on-one, how should he do it?
And what was his answer?
Don't. He swore there's no way in hell a single infantryman could take down a tank by himself.
I think he was sneaky. Besides, grenades are a viable tactic.
I always suspected there was a little something crazy about you, Snake. But hearing that story, now I know it. You're nuts! Single-handedly taking out a tank? That's crazy! You're insane!
Otacon, is this your idea of a compliment?
Yes!
Oh.
You're the toughest, craziest, most hardcore badass on the planet! You're the shit!
Oh god, the delivery. You're the shit! It was all leading up to that. Thanks, Otacon. Remember those times when you had to run all the way to the end over here? Grab the ration and run all the way back? Okay, well, I'm full up, but those times are over. Yeah, look at that. Oh boy. Let's see if he has anything to say about the warheads.
I believe the warheads have been removed from those nuclear missiles. The amount of ionizing radiation the Mark III's Geiger counter is detecting is significantly lower than what we'd see if there were actual warheads present. Which means, obviously, that you can use heavy weapons without having to worry about igniting leaking radioactive material and causing a nuclear holocaust.
Good. Nice.
Oh, man. I don't remember that response from Snake. Nice. It's good.
I don't see any enemies around here. Okay, we'll go through the door all the way at the back.
Otacon, last time around, we had a few complications and wound up going through the commander's office in the basement.
That's right. I remember now. But there's no need to go all the way down there this time, right? The back door takes us straight where we need to go.
Good point.
Okay, then.
Snake doesn't want to do that. He wants to go and relive the memories of going all the way through the commander's office again. Honestly, I would have liked to have seen, like, the commander's office, but, oh well. Man, what the hell was that? 10,000 Drevin points? Is there anything else? We got grenades. Alright, never mind. Okay, well, I guess that's all of it. What is up?
Huh? Snake, that door is locked.
How do I open it?
Security is shut down altogether. You can't release the lock without activating it. You'll have to log in somewhere. I've got it, Snake. My old office is close by. With the power on, you should be able to unlock the door from there. And if you check the facility records, we can find out Rex's status and who's been in and out. You remember where it is, Snake?
I'm not senile yet.
Just to be safe, I'm marking it on your map. You old geezer.
Please.
Snake, the password is 48273. Think you can remember that?
I told you, I'm not senile. Yet.
Okay.
Snake, I've checked the APU on this floor and engaged the generator. Energy output is low, but it should be enough to power the elevator. Try the elevator and see if it's working.
I'm already here. There we go. Still operational, that's good. So, the commander's office is conveniently locked out.
Okay, first go down the central hallway. Don't worry, it's not electrified anymore.
Yeah, but do we know that for sure? So, am I able to, like, bust through here? Shit. I guess you couldn't originally, could you? There's gotta be all sorts of good stuff in there.
Everything looks exactly like I remember it. Except for that wall way in back, anyway. I still can't believe how much damage you caused in such a small space.
Ah, the switchboard. Nailed it with a remote control missile to shut down the electric current in the floor. The guidance system and those things takes up so much space, it hardly leaves any room for explosives.
Didn't make much of a bang, huh?
Hardly. Switchboard's still intact.
You're right. The wiring past the switch circuits could still be alive.
Good.
Wait a minute. I'm not gonna get shocked if I walk on this floor, am I?
No need to worry. As long as you don't turn the current back on.
Little hint for future events. Whoops, that's not what I meant to do. I guess I can't get into any of these, can I? Crazy time back then. Down. He's taking the Mark III with him.
Snake, that password I told you before, you remember it, right?
Of course I remember it.
Because I completely forgot. Can you punch it in for me?
Sure.
It's a 5-digit number.
That's it, right? Actually, there's a number of codes I think you could put in here. There's like Drebin's frequency will give you Drebin points. Some stuff for iPod music, but I'm pretty sure I've gotten all that. You know what thing? The thing that bugs me though is if you get it wrong, or say you put in boobs into the security code, just for you know giggles. he says, Snake, I think your memory, you might be going senile here. But then Otacon, you're the one that forgot in the first place. So what gives, man? 48273. I'm pretty sure. Let's see. Yay.
Nice job. At least your memory hasn't gone bad.
This future tech from the late 90s.
This version is totally obsolete. It's gonna take a little work. This is the room where we first met, huh?
Remember when you pissed yourself?
It's not conjuring up any unpleasant memories, is it?
A little bit.
I was being attacked by Frank Yeager.
Yeah, I remember.
If you hadn't shown up when you did, it gives me the shivers just thinking about it. Snake, you saved my life.
Naomi hated them for what they did to Frank's body. But it was me that crippled him in the first place. She must have hated me too.
Yeah, but that's what he wanted. Hand-to-hand combat.
We shouldn't have been so trusting. I blame myself too. I helped develop Rex. That's why it was so easy for me to believe her feelings were genuine. But she was only using us to atone for her sins.
So what? What did she do to us?
You forgot already? She betrayed you. She stole your blood.
If that was all, it should have been over and done with in South America. Why'd she join us afterward?
Well,
she has us come rescue her, and then she turns around and goes straight back to Liquid. Why would she do that?
I don't know, Snake. But it looks like she's still with him.
What?
I just had a look at the security access logs. As I thought, there's people coming and going at frequent intervals. In fact, the records show some recent activity. Look at this. It's an image taken a few hours ago by a surveillance camera up ahead.
Naomi.
And Vamp.
The Beauty and the Beast.
Been through here. And from what we've gleaned from the security records, it can only mean one thing. They're headed for Rex's old underground hangar. I finished rebooting security and released the locks. The door on the first floor ought to open for you now.
Amazing. Almost makes me nostalgic for the days when you needed a keycard.
I don't know about that.
Yep. 9 years. All you really have to do is reinterpret the old technology in terms of the new. Getting old isn't all that bad, you know. Let's get going, Snake.
I finished unlocking the door on the first floor. It should open now.
Did they actually, like, texture the stain in here?
I've
yeah, they did.
For you, Snake. Who are you? Neither enemy nor friend.
That's gross.
Gray Fox. Colonel, that ninja is Gray Fox. Gray Fox. Ridiculous. Ridiculous. You yourself in Zanzibar Land.
Yes. He should have been killed, but he's still alive.
What?
They were using a soldier for their gene therapy experiments.
How long are you gonna stay in there? Huh? Are you one of them? No, I'm not. I always work alone.
Alone?
You in a taco too?
Come on, get out.
Key relating words to a taco, alone. So we got the police announce poster here. It's looking a little less, defined than it was. Also, I think, was there a second police announce? Was it just two police announce posters? Because I don't remember this one. I don't know what that is. So there used to be a PlayStation right here. Original PlayStation. Not anymore, though. Those days are gone. Somebody must have taken it on their way out. It equipped. What don't I need? The camera? Sounds good to me. Oh shit. No, I did not mean to knock on the door. I was actually seeing. God damn it. If it had a cloaking feature. Because I haven't controlled this thing in a while. Go away. Just turn around. Turn around. Oh, yeah. Actually, the range on the Mark II is cutting out.
Snake, you're about to send the Mark
or three, whatever.
Range. Watch out.
There we go.
Okay. Nice, Snake.
Okay, hopefully that's off. Yeah. Okay, I think we're good to go. Come out of the elevator at some point. I'm wondering if standing here is a good thing. Okay, not right this moment, I guess.
Okay, Snake. Take the stairs down and go to the north door.
Jump down.
I'll open it for you with the Mark III.
What to do. That's the elevator to come out of, alright. How do they fit in there?
Oh man, more Gecko! The Mark III is totally defenseless while working on the door. You'll have to distract the Gecko so they don't spot it.
Can do. Then I'll just need to put it back on again. Oh boy. Back into the blizzard. Say about this?
The comm towers. This is where you fought Liquid's Hind D.
That was a tough scrape.
But you still managed to shoot down his gunship. Up till then, I'd heard that even with a man pads, going one-on-one against an attack chopper was an act of suicide. I thought only Hollywood action stars.
What's a man's pads? Kind of
thing, but you made it look easy.
I just told you, it wasn't that easy.
Really? But you were all like, oh, I had to take out that helicopter. Real cool. Like it was nothing.
All right, enough chit-chat. Let's get going. We got a long way to go to Rex's hangar.
Yeah, you're right, Snake.
Oh, yeah, I had to take out that helicopter. Why are you mocking Snake, Otacon? Is that it? There's something else in here. I guess they give you a sniper rifle, but it's not so good. Oh boy, this boss battle can be a real pain. Not a good time.
Go on.
Frogs, good. Yeah, you know, I remember when I was doing the big boss run. This part was a huge, huge pain in the ass. Oh man, it sucked. But I managed to do it. Don't know how. I'm kind of, afraid of this part when it comes down to doing the big boss run again. Not looking forward to it. Really not. Might as well get my practice in, though. Where the hell's my Mosin Nagant? Oh, there it is. I like the sleep gas mines, too. Those protect me when I'm up on the, up on the thing, the towers. Okay, I really can't see you, so... The thing is, there's a lot of them, too. So you get the frogs to deal with, and you have the time-consuming nature of this fight. So that's another thing. Sometimes you could luck it out and, like, get... A lot of good hits on the wolf, though. That was too slow. I kind of don't like streaming this because I usually do the night vision during this run, which, doesn't bother me from a purely gaming perspective, but it's not the most pleasing thing to look at. Out again. What? Oh shit. Cool. Why the hell did she know I was up there? I was like kind of shocked that there was like something laying down but moving at the same time. I'm not sure what to think of that. So I think the Konami code works on this fight too. Maybe. It's kind of like when you use Konami code in the end boss battle. It reveals his location on the map. I feel like the same thing was doable in this boss battle, but I don't really want to get cheap at the moment. I know I heard that case open. The face camo back on. There we go. God damn it. I hear her to the right. But then I think I see activity to the left, so I'm not too sure. That's not her, is it? Oh shit. Where are they? I don't even see them. She sees me. Ah, shit. I hate it when she's been there. I can never see her when she's in the forested section. Such pain in the dick. Like it came from above. She's coming here. All right, good deal. No. Oh. Asshole. Moved at the last second. Okay, so gotta do some tracking. Did I get her? Didn't really look like it, did it? Oh shit. I spy me a wolf? I do indeed. God, they're everywhere. No, don't wake him up. Please. Oh, is that her again? Yes! No! Oh, God! Trying to get down here. Oh, thank you. Stay asleep. Okay. Where did you go off to? Is it? I think that's a frog, yeah. Shit. Oh wow, I actually hit her. Over there. Seems like she went this way and didn't quite turn around. Okay. I was afraid she was gonna be like right around the corner. Oh, I think I see her. Yep, that is her. Damn it, need one more. Shit! Yes! Oh, thank God. Alright, well that wasn't terrible, but still took a little while.
Stop it! Stop crying!
Striker pose. No, we already did the laughing octopus. We don't need to do it again.
Don't come any closer.
Am I gonna stream Metal Gear Survive? I don't know that I'm gonna get Metal Gear Survive, but we'll see when it comes out.
I'm sorry.
So welcome to the stream lane.
I was so scared.
Hear those babbies crying in the background.
Forgive me. I'm sorry. You can cry if you want. Cry if you need to.
What would I do if I bought it without looking into it and I popped it in and the first thing I see is a Hideo Kojima game? I wouldn't be surprised. Honestly, I wouldn't care if Kojima was behind it.
I've cried myself
dry. I've never been a online person, and I've never been a zombie person, so that's like two strikes against the game that I'm not into.
As much as you like.
So notice how their suits look like negligee. Looks like she's wearing some sort of boobless corset, garter belt, and stockings. Oh baby. Oh man, you took away my... Ah, goddamn you. Game. Taking away my twin barrel. Here's the thing about Metal Gear Survive. We don't know anything about it at this point. We don't know if it's been in development since the Phantom Pain has been around, so I don't know if Kojima's put any thought behind it. You know. The only thing that we know so far is what we've seen in the trailer, and then it's not going to be a full price tag game, so that's good. If it was like DLC or something, I wouldn't, I'm not so opposed to it, but they said it's more along the lines of Ground Zeroes, where it's an add-on. There we go. I don't know why, but the twin barrel makes short work of them. Even the Moza Nagant doesn't take him out in three hits. But I think the vitriol and the outrage for Survive just initially is somewhat funny. Oh, you know what I forgot to do? I forgot to do the codec call during this battle. Ah, shit. Whatever. Whatever. Both Otacon and Rose say almost the same thing for every boss battle. It's just the iteration of whatever emotion they're currently... the boss is currently on.
Snake, I finished laundering that rail gun you picked up just now.
Oh boy.
Knock yourself out. It's on the house.
Thanks.
Time for another bedtime story, Snake. This one's about Crying Wolf. You don't need me to tell you there's whole nations in Africa tearing themselves apart in the name of ethnic cleansing. Well, she was born into that environment. When she was a little girl, her village was attacked by rival armed factions. Her parents and siblings were slaughtered, and she was left a refugee. She took her last surviving relative, her baby brother, and ran as far as she could away from the war zone. One day, they came across an enemy unit, so she took her brother and hid in an abandoned shack. And then her brother started to cry. She knew that if the soldiers heard the noise, they would find them and kill them both. So she wrapped her hand as tight as she could around his mouth. As the footsteps gradually went away, she came back to her senses. Her brother wasn't crying anymore. Horrified, she pulled her hand away, covered in sweat and spit. He wasn't breathing. They say wolves eat their own pups when they die. She was spotted wandering through the thick of battle, carrying...
I don't know if he's, like, implying something there or what.
She had visions, too. A wolf walking alongside her. Every night, the wolf would howl and cry, just like her brother did that day. Eventually, she made it to a government-run refugee camp. But by then, her brother's body had rotted away.
But did she eat her brother's body along the way? I'm confused.
And little children like her brother. Day and night, she was tormented by the cries of babies. The wolf that followed her heard her sorrowful screams and answered. He made his way around the camp, and one by one, he silenced the children. She tried to stop it, but she was powerless to stop the wolf. A few days passed, and on the eve of the enemy's raid, there wasn't a child left. The adults who survived were torn up pretty bad. Of course, there was never any wolf in that camp. She was the one who killed those babies. But she couldn't bring herself to admit it. She couldn't bear the thought of herself going from one baby to the next, howling like a wolf, snuffing out their little lives. And she never did. Even as Crying Wolf, a lonely beast forever stalking the battlefield. Snake, fighting with you made Wolf finally accept what she'd done. She was cleansed by you. If the cries she heard of children on the battlefield have been silenced, it's because of you. You ought to be proud. Three down, one to go. All that's left is Mantis. But you should know, Snake, she's been controlling all the other beasts. She's the beast of beasts. Don't let her get her hooks in you.
I won't.
See you around, Snake.
No such personal details about them. It's a little creepy.
Welcome home, Wolf.
But what will happen to the wolves when Shadow Moses sinks? Can we have like a venom snake or something knock him out and put him onto a floating sea base? I just all need to get Fultoned. He's like, I don't really care for this. Curious as to where they took her, but Snake wasn't as curious. Alright, well, there's a few flashback stuff to go around here, so...
Snake! What was she fighting for? What am I fighting for? What are you fighting for?
If we make it through this, I'll tell you.
Okay. I'll be searching.
Oh good, they like me. Alright. I wasn't quite sure when I heard it running behind me. I'm like, oh shit. I thought they did, but then those thoughts receded. Pretty sure there's one over here. Oh yeah, there it is.
Meryl.
War is meaningless. Nothing comes out of war. Snake, please. Save yourself. Go on living and don't give up on people.
And I did not even hear that "don't forget me." Lizard must be coming in strong. I think there's one more. Let's see. Thought it was over here. Maybe it's a little further up. No, I don't think it's further up. It must still be down here. I just can't see it. There it is.
Come on, fly!
See you in hell, Liquid. And how did he survive? Dogs, please. How did he survive this? Liquid Snake was a tough son of a bitch. Alright. I think that's it for this area. I don't think Otacon says anything. Let's see. Well, we already talked about the Hind, though.
Oh, you really had to take out that helicopter.
Hear that, Snake?
Yeah.
Oh. I guess we'll talk about the wolf dogs.
Her family. It must be tough for them in this environment with all the people gone.
Wolf dogs aren't like other dogs. They're closer to wolves in nature. Happier living in the wild than being kept as pets. Even more so now that they're guarding the grave of a loved one.
You sure about that?
Trust me. I used to live with dogs just like these. I know what I'm talking about.
Okay. If you say so.
I wonder if Snake ever went back to that. I guess not. After Metal Gear 2, he took up into Alaska and became a musher for a few years, and then ever since Metal Gear Solid, he's just been fighting Metal Gear with Otacon. Maybe after. Be able to live his life. Play with his dogs. Dogs coming in here. You guys coming? Alright, come on. Let's go. I don't think they're coming. Oh man, there's a lot of them coming in here though. Or over here, rather. Alright, we'll see you later.
Hold it, Snake. Time to change the disc. I know, it's a pain. But you need to swap disc 1 for disc 2. You see the disc labeled 2?
I don't think so.
No.
Huh? Oh, wait. We're on PlayStation 3. It's a Blu-ray disc. Dual layered, too. No need to swap.
Damn it, Otacon. Get a grip.
Yeah, what an age we live in, huh, Snake? Wonder what they'll think of next.
I like to think that Snake just hung up on him. That's why I ended it so abruptly. What an age we live in. Oh boy, Blu-ray discs. PlayStation 3s. This is truly a future worth living in. Oh yeah, this music is vaguely reminiscent of Metal Gear Solid soundtrack. It's pretty cool. I don't think it's anything worth getting down there. Any words to say here, Otacon?
The cargo elevator down to Rex's hangar is ahead. It's that big door in the back, on the right. Head through that door and keep going.
Alright. I guess not. B5.
Snake. I've got something to tell you about Naomi Hunter.
What about her?
She might be a spy.
To kill me? Is that all you cared about?
Frank Yeager. The man who you destroyed was my brother and my only family.
Great Fox.
You killed my benefactor and sent my brother home a cripple. I vowed revenge.
But I can't go yet. I still have a job to do.
I vowed revenge.
What a bitch. Naomi, please. That'd be such a pain in the ass. I forget which way I like taking. I think I go to the right usually. Seems to be the simplest. Gecko up there. Although it is really close. How do I want to do this? Regular gecko are affected by the chaff grenades, right? They damn well better be. Shit, I can't go that way. God damn it. Alright, and they're not affected by the chaff. Okay, good to know. I thought they were. Alright, well, I'm boned. Oh boy. I think I can use the Barrett while in a prone position. Or, you know, the 50 cal. I'll have to remember that for next time, then. What is this camo pattern? Shit! Oh, man. Alright, well, that could have been better. Could have been worse. But definitely could have been better. That way.
Rex is on the floor above you. Use the lift.
Oh wait, I've been missing stuff like this. You got anything to say about this Areoticon?
Snake, I went ahead and remotely sent the lift used to bring Rex up to the supply tunnel. So then, all aboard.
Awfully cheery. All right. See it? What does it look like after all these years?
Look, the railgun.
Pretty much the
same.
Except no railgun.
Liquid doesn't need the whole Rex to launch his nuke. He only needs the railgun.
Damn it. Has it already been shipped?
Hang on, I'll check.
It's a convenient spot for an access port.
I'm afraid so. Unfortunately for you. The railgun is no longer here.
Man, she's touching his cock knife. Ugh, she's got his hands all over him. That's gross.
Naomi.
This place will be your grave, as my queen wishes. The suicide gecko are on their way. Soon, there'll be nothing left of this place.
We've been had. Oticon.
Snake, I think I might be able to get it working. I just need some time.
She's obviously playing him, but it seems so obvious. Maybe Vamp finally thought he found someone as eccentric as he is.
I'll leave the rest to you.
Naomi!
Excellent. You'll amuse me until they arrive.
Take care of Rex. You take Vamp. Kill that monster. Get Naomi back, Snake. Please.
Take this.
I don't want it. Okay, what do we want to use? Let's do something. I don't know. I'm gonna try a handgun. Let's do. Is that Desert Eagle? Ooh, it is. What's up, Artillery 23? Welcome to the stream. This thing has some kick to it. Ooh. Hey, how did I take so much damage already? It sounds like it damages him a bit, but it really doesn't. So that's unfortunate. What else do we want to try? Let's try the Mark 23. Not so good, even with a couple headshots in there. All right. Well, let's see. What else do we got in our bag of goodies here? What about the Tanegashima? Does this do anything? Oh yeah, love that reload time. Come on, vamp.
Vanished.
Vanished. Oh, please. Oh, wow. Where are you looking? Nope. Wait. Okay. It wasn't worth the shot. You know what does work, though, is the, where is it? Where's the solar gun? Is that under handguns? Ah, there it is. Oh. I gotta charge it up, I guess. Also, I better take a ration, otherwise I'm gonna die here. There we go.
Yes! You did it, Snake!
Oh man, he's burning up. He's a real vampire. Did you know that vamp is short for vampire? Man, this guy's really oblivious. Okay, so you know what I don't think I have in my inventory? Oh, I still have signal intelligence. That's dumb. So yeah, let's switch that out for the syringe so we can get this over with. I'm gonna see if I can pop a headshot in him though. Just, you know, for old time's sake. Oh, what the? Also, we have to do this. There we go.
It's no use.
All right.
Time to finish.
Whoa! I didn't even know he threw anything at me. I think after knocking him out once, headshots instant KO him, so let's see. Shit. There we go. Well, that was quicker than I thought it was gonna be, so sorry, y'all dud cell. Rest of us.
What have you done?
There. Now you're a mere mortal, like the rest of us.
A little more gruff than that, but alright.
Never. But can you kill this mere mortal?
Snake, sorry to have kept you all waiting.
You ready for this?
Sonny gave me the go-ahead.
So, this part is, like, fun for you guys. You get to watch a cool fight scene. Me, on the other hand.
Care to die too.
Sorry, but I can't die just yet.
Then kill me.
Snake, this one is mine. You keep those gecko at bay.
His hand. Fine. Life fight.
Suicide gecko. They blow up and they take us with them. You've got to keep them back. I'm sending you data on where to aim. Put a bullet through their brains.
Ooh. That was a fully charged. A lot of knifing going on. That's all I could tell. Oh, here we go.
Damn! Here they come again! Hang in there, Snake! Don't give up!
Swear I saw one. Oh, here it is.
Above you! They're coming from above!
Again. Where's it coming from? Thought I heard one over here. Others. Shit. Ryan's getting wrecked. Ah. Oh, wow. Yeah, that's really close. Well, there's actually one, like, right in front of me. Staggering. Oh, come on, go for the killing blow. I think this is it. There we go.
He was never immortal. His natural healing abilities were enhanced by the nanomachines inside his body. But, after so many battles, he's finally reached his limit.
Doctor, ease my pain.
Yeah, he's all veiny and such. Just let him suffer. I'm fanging out.
Sonny asked me to tell you something.
What is it?
I cooked them right.
I see. Good for you, Sonny. You finally did it. No, I can't save you. You have to trust me, Dr. Emmer. Give this to him.
Not for revenge, but to end his suffering.
Snake. Liquid's down below us. He's stolen the Patriot system, slipped out of their sight, and taken their Ark.
Ark?
A warship. Unfettered by land, law, country, or network. The only place where they are truly released from the shackles of the Patriots. The place where they can be free. Outer Haven.
Outer Haven?
Liquid plans to launch the nuke from that ship. Snake. You have been given life so that you may fulfill your purpose. When all of this is over, you'll have no choice but to accept death. We are given life only so that we can atone for our sins. Your life was created for that very purpose. We all must atone for our own sins. We must not pass them on to the next generation. We must not leave them for the future. That is your true fate. One that even you cannot defy.
There was like a special Chantress. It's just like every time that she's been using the syringe.
We are the same. We're living corpses.
Her, what is it, cancer?
Our bodies
just keeps progressing.
Then you.
Cancer. I shouldn't even be alive right now. The nanomachines have kept it from progressing. But there's nothing more they can do. With the nanomachines gone, time will unfreeze and begin to flow again.
What are you saying? Goodbye.
Strong. Naomi wasn't that great anyway.
Thank you.
I haven't lost everything yet. I've still got a job to do.
That's right. We need you.
I'm done crying. I don't have any more tears to shed. We have to get out of here.
Any ideas?
Time's running short, so I'll explain as we go. Pay close attention.
I'm listening.
Oh boy, here we go. To say about this, Otacon, aside from what you're saying right now.
Get to the port area at the end of the supply tunnel as fast All right. as you can.
I'm sorry things had to happen that way, Snake. But there'll be time to mourn later. For now, you have to get out of there as fast as you can. Go.
Well, talking to you always makes me feel better. Time to be a hero riding. Oh good. I keep looking at that HP bar and it keeps getting lower and lower and lower. Well, looks like I made it. Also, Ryan, what are you doing looking at the explosion? Come on, man. Just surpasses expectations.
Snake,
Genesis, where our fates were born, and where yours ends, Snake.
Here we go. Oh yeah.
Right after you dodge.
There we go. Already got a fin off.
And wait for your chance to counterattack.
Oh shit. Oh, nowhere to go. Wrong way. God damn it, I missed that prompt. Oh man, I missed it. Ugh. Oh shit, misses. Damn it, I was charging that laser too. Gotcha. Thank you.
think again. Sorry, but that won't work this time.
Look, what's the ultimate in the ruse, Master?
Behold!
Also, upcoming is my favorite animation ever. It should be this next one, right here. Let's get a good look at Mount Snakemore. Suspend my belief for this. You're pushing it, Raiden. Hidden flashbacks.
They were asking me which building it was that King Kong was climbing in the movie. I said it was probably the Chrysler. And then you showed up and started mouthing off. You were like, no, it's the Empire State.
I said the Chrysler building was in Godzilla.
We started arguing, and I forgot all about the tourists.
The next thing we knew, the tourists had gone away. And a week later, I found you again by coincidence out in the base corridor.
An amazing coincidence.
That night, we went up to the top of the Empire State Building.
It was so beautiful.
I didn't care anymore who was right.
And that was our first date.
We watched King Kong in your apartment a bunch of times that night. Didn't sleep till morning.
Thank you.
worthless fossil.
Just a sword now. Okay, so that's almost it for me. I think I'm going to do the mission briefing, which is actually pretty long, but just so we can jump right into the game next time and finish this bad boy off.
Haven is headed southward through the Pacific at a speed of 33 knots. The Missouri is falling behind at a rate of about 2 nautical miles every hour.
Can't this thing go any faster?
I'm afraid not. This is as fast as she'll go. Liquid's target is JD, a U.S. military satellite disguised as orbital debris. Oh. Haven will have to surface in order to use the railgun.
If we can figure out JD's orbit...
there we go.
We should be able to predict where Haven's gonna surface.
JD is in a synchronous elliptical orbit, so its next perigee should be in,
Got it! 15 hours, 6 minutes, and 12 seconds.
Right. In 15 hours, it's going to be over the Bering Sea.
Mei-Ling, please.
494 nautical miles up. From the Bering Strait. Haven knows it too. They'll be holding position in that area.
Do they really have to get that close to launch?
The nukes fired by Rex's railgun have a damage radius of approximately 300 meters. The target is a moving satellite that's traveling at 10 kilometers per second.
Trying to help you out, buddy.
To get the precision they need, they have to get as close as they possibly can.
Liquid won't launch his nuke until JD is at perigee. The Missouri can use that time to catch up.
Will we make it?
Once Haven stops moving, it'll take us an hour to close the gap. After that, the Missouri needs to strike before Haven's launch preparations are complete. This ship was stripped of most of its equipment, and she's got no electronic warfare capabilities of any kind. No radar, no high-tech weaponry. We'll have to rely on our own eyes to track the enemy. From the looks of it, Haven is going to use a railgun mounted on the bridge to destroy JD. You'll need to open the cover to launch the nuke. That's our one and only chance to get inside.
Inside? Why can't we attack it from here?
It wouldn't do any good. As long as Liquid has control of the system, physically destroying GW would still leave supreme authority in his hands. Sons of the Patriots.
Yes. Dr. Emmerich is right. That's why we need to destroy GW from the inside, before attacking Haven itself.
Liquid's very own Death Star.
No one likes movies here?
All right, everybody. Here's the plan. We know Haven will have to surface in order to fire the railgun. When it does, the Missouri will see it. We'll make a quick approach and deliver a strike team. Our goal is twofold. Prevent that nuke from launching and wipe out GW's program.
Oh, I miss paramedic.
The enemy relies entirely on electronic means of threat detection.
She would have gotten
it. So
they
won't be able to see the
Missouri. Whoa, Johnny. What the hell is your problem? Christ.
We'll launch the strike team from catapults at the exact moment Haven's armored cover opens. They'll then penetrate GW's physical server room and infect it with a worm cluster.
But what if they shut down GW before we get in there?
Liquid is already entrenched within the Patriots network. He needs to stay there, or destroying JD won't serve him any purpose. They can't afford to have GW shut down.
And let's not forget, Liquid will throw everything he's got at stopping the strike team.
Exactly. The corridor leading to GW is defended by directed energy weapons that emit certain types of microwaves.
Did you say microwaves?
That's right. And at that frequency, the waves will start to evaporate any living person within range.
A giant microwave oven. You'd have to have a death wish to go in there. Sounds like the perfect job for me.
Snake, this isn't the time for your stupid jokes.
Outside the corridor, Liquid soldiers will be out in full force. Inside, there'll be unmanned weapons waiting for us.
Where are you getting all this information? You really think there's a way to destroy GW?
Yes, I do. She left us something that'll point us in the right direction.
Naomi helped with the preparations to stop Haven's launch.
Naomi.
All of our internal data on Haven came from her. The reason she got on the Nomad with us in the first place was to get close to me. But she ended up turning to Sunny instead.
What do you mean?
She left her plan in Sunny's hands.
This entire operation is based on the data she left us.
Whose side was she on, anyway?
We'll never know exactly what her true intentions were. But one thing's for sure. She was determined to stop Liquid.
Promise. Promise.
Come on, guys. Somebody say something positive. Anything.
Snake.
Attention. Listen up. A wise man once wrote, "The tongues of dying men enforce attention like deep harmony. Where words are spent, they are seldom spent in vain."
Anybody get that? No?
Any other questions? Yes, Snake?
Anybody got a smoke?
Snake.
No. No! Be happy. There you go. Enjoy your smoke.
So this program, you're saying Sunny wrote it?
Actually, only about a third of it is her work. Naomi was working on a program to destroy GW, but she couldn't quite finish it. So she handed it over to Sunny. Sunny went fishing in my library to see if there was any source code she could use to complete it. Eventually, she found some. It was Emma's worm cluster.
Let's try not to remember Emma too much.
She took my sister's code and worked it into Naomi's program. I didn't have time to look over every single line.
Where's that reflection coming from?
But what I did see reminded me of Emma. It was like she left traces of herself behind in the structure. But this worm cluster that Sunny created, it's even better than Emma's. Sunny's worm destroys the AI's intellect by triggering apoptosis in the cells. Once uploaded into GW, it should do some real damage. Snake, you ever think about quitting?
Why? It's not like I've got my health to worry about.
Are you trying to kill yourself? So, you're dead set on going to Haven yourself. Why don't we get somebody else to go? There's no need for you to do it.
I still have things left to do. Besides smoke.
So, I've still got things to do myself. And I don't even smoke.
All right. Might as well let the next one play out.
This is my first real engagement.
I see. Your point?
Yeah, so?
At first, getting assigned to this ship was a big letdown for me. But the inaction was kind of a relief, too. Captain. I'm scared.
It's okay. I'm scared, too. This is also my first time. But I'm not going to let it get to me. Because I'm more scared of what'll happen if I run away. Nobody is going to die on my watch. This ship is going back to Hawaii in one piece. That, I promise.
Right.
Thank you. Who are you again? Nameless cadet.
He's in no shape to fight. Best to let him rest.
Right.
Without the system to protect them, everybody's losing their nerve. They say SOP's after effects are so bad that a lot of soldiers are deserting.
The only people I have left to rely on are Marilyn. Him.
Kind of an unknown quantity, isn't he?
I hooked him up with a 9ID M82. Fancy meeting you here.
What are you doing here?
Just about to ask that.
I laundered these guys' IDs, then issued them new naked weapons. Including that catapult you're gonna be riding.
Like how that's like the number one option to get in there.
Business has been slow ever since Liquid got his hands on the system. His extra orders stopped coming in. Now that all the weapons all over the world are locked, the only one still looking to fight would be you and yours. They tell me it's not economical to replace all that useless equipment on the battlefield with my stuff. So I made an extra special trip out here, just for you.
Drevin, do you even have the slightest idea what's going on here?
Of course I do.
Oh, the monkey came too. Good.
See, when it comes down to it, the world's like this soda here. Once the bubbles are gone, I ain't got no use for it. It's worth nothing. I'm on the side of whoever needs me the most. You dig?
See, I had a friend who had a cousin that used to open up soda and let it sit until the carbonation was gone.
If you need anything, just say the word. I'm setting up shop here for a spell.
It was gross. I hate flat coke. It's nasty. Yep.
Enjoy it. Could be your last.
Ah, Drevin, is there anything you can't do?
Like that last smoke will have to wait after all. Later.
Hey. Here.
Oh. Oh, thanks.
That's reaction. Oh, he's tickled to death that he got a soda. Boy, just the three of us. Wow. Good team.
Snake, can you hear me? Liquid's warship, Outer Haven, is a modified version of an Arsenal gear model stolen from the Patriots. Inside, it's crawling with Irving and other unmanned weapons. According to Naomi's data, Haven is crewed by a battalion of enhanced soldiers, each called from the best the PMCs have to offer. If Liquid succeeds in destroying JD and gaining control of the Patriot system, he'll make Haven his flagship, and his PMCs will spread like wildfire across the globe. And then, mankind's armed subjugation will begin.
Captain, Haven sighted.
Prepare to fire, main gun!
Gun is exposed.
There it is. A naked nuke.
Let's finish it, Snake. Let this be our last battle. If we're responsible for Liquid sins, then the onus is ours to bear.
Right.
Moving to intercept!
Maintain full speed!
Failure will spell doom for the human race. You've got to stop them from using that railgun. Then annihilate GW.
Fire!
Not very much. Rest in peace, Johnny. It's hard to believe there wasn't, like, a grapple system or parachutes they could wear. Maybe something that they could use to glide in. Nope, just catapult yourselves in there. Good enough.
Snake!
Where are you?
Sorry, it's my ankle.
Can you walk?
I think so.
He did do a nice flip. Welcome to the stream, guys.
He fell into the ocean. Snake, I'll catch up soon. You go ahead.
Ooh. They're gone.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
The first few times I played this, I wasn't aware that you can, you know, like, stealth your way through here.
Snake, can you hear me? GW is toward the ship's stern. Hurry!
But you'll notice it's in caution mode and not actually alert.
Good job, Snake.
Also, sorry, Atacon, I gotta cut you off. Oh, boy. Everything's half off a driven shop, eh? Well, we'll have to mess with all this next time. A hell of a cliffhanger, huh? Sorry, guys. Just gonna have to wait another week. I know. I kind of want to finish it myself, but then I know with the cutscenes and everything, it's gonna be another 3 hours, and I kind of got to bounce right now. So sorry. But there will, of course, be another Metal Gear Monday next week, and we'll finish off Guns of the Patriots. Should be fun. Thank you guys for watching, though. Oh, wow. And they take chest and headshots like a pro. Did I ever understand why the frogs turn to dust when you kill them? Are they clones? No. They're just elite soldiers that are grabbed from around the world. They turn to dust because of the nanomachines. Basically, it's like a way of protecting company secrets. I guess you could say. The nanomachines burn the body from the inside out so that no one can steal the tech that they have on them. Oh, Death didn't see either. Thanks for watching. Thanks all you guys. Hopefully we'll see you here next week to watch the finale of Guns of the Patriots. Pretty big deal. I dig it. I love this game a lot, though, and I love the ending. Especially the final boss fight, that's gonna be fun. But yeah, I can't wait. Just gotta wait one more week, and we'll finish it off. It's been feels like it's been a long journey. But yeah, it's already coming to an end. Hopefully I'll be by tomorrow. I would like to continue Final Fantasy X, so I don't know if you guys are interested in that or not. Yeah, FF10 maybe tomorrow, and then the day after. We'll do some more Wolfenstein, and yeah, those are my three big games for right now. Final Fantasy X, Wolfenstein The New Order, and Guns of the Patriots, which I will be finishing next week. Still my favorite MGS game of all time. It's a really, really fun one. I dig it a lot, and I'm really enjoying actually watching all the cutscenes this time around, because the past few times I've played through this, I've just been skipping them. So, you know, just to get to gameplay a little bit quicker, but watching through them again, it's been a little while. It's there's a lot of stuff that I tend to forget and little things to pick up on, so it's been a trip, man. Been really fun. But yep, next week we are gonna be finishing it off, so sad, but there'll be more Metal Gear after that. I don't know what I'm gonna do next though. Maybe Ghost Babble or something? I haven't streamed that yet. I've already done every main series game, so hard to say. Anyway, take care, you guys. And maybe we'll see you around next time. Have a good night.